Hello friends, welcome back to the workshop. It's been a while, but I have something big to share with you today. If you have ever been frustrated by the mesh triangles in SolidWorks, then you better to stick around. In SolidWorks 2025, the issue is finally addressed, and I'm proud to say that I had my hand in making this happen. But how? It actually started on 3D Experience World, and now I will take you to this journey with me. Now, let's see a little bit about the story behind this change. As you already know from my channel, probably if you have seen these videos, I've been on 3D Experience World twice. It's a great event because you have the chance to see the newest tech in SolidWorks and in the world, also to meet the R&D team and management of the SOS systems. Of course, you can just see them or you can talk with them and discuss some ideas. And on one of the 3D Experience Worlds, I was talking with a person from the R&D team about STL and how SolidWorks is actually handling STL. Then I pointed out something which a lot of you are annoyed from, and that's when you import STL object to a mesh body, the triangles remain visual. So if you have to put a part which is made with combination of STL import and building in SolidWorks and you start to make drawing, these mesh triangles are visible also in the drawing. A lot of users have asked me in the past if there is a way to hide these triangle lines, and the only option available is to go only to shaded view. This is not comfortable because in shaded only view, you're missing the outer edges. However, it was a workaround. Now, I was extremely surprised after my talk with the people from the R&D, in which I shared for this annoying little feature, that nobody paid attention to that. And they agreed that this is actually really unnecessary and the lines could be removed. And guess my surprise, when I started SolidWorks 2025 and I made a normal convert to mesh body, this is what happened. So you can imagine my excitement when I saw this change implemented so soon after this conversation. Of course, it's a big positive for me. I hope it's also a big positive for you. But this changes a little bit the way we should work in STL and SolidWorks now, if you want to have the maximum of this new feature. Now, let's see some things we can do with SolidWorks now when the mesh triangles are not visible to have a better look of our imported mesh models. When you're converting to mesh body, you have this option here, group facets into faces. When it's checked, it will try to recognize different faces and give you most of the contours on your exported model. However, sometimes this is not working. When this is not working, you will receive one complete body with just outer lines. To fix this, click on the converted body and select Segment Imported Mesh Body. You will have a preview in purple lines of the segments that will be created. Here on Options, you have Angle Tolerance, which when you adjust, it will remove or add more lines. In the case of this model, I have some extra lines, so I have to decrease the tolerance until they disappear and I have just the important ones. That was cool, isn't it? Now, a small reminder, if you enjoyed the video, give it a like and let's see what else we can improve in this STL look. Now, I have all top and bottom edges. Also here, You can see I have the edges, and then I can just select OK and close. You can do also segmenting on more than one step. Once you have segmented your imported mesh body, but every additional will work on certain segment. And it was that easy. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you next time. Bye bye.